Requesting electronic signatures from one or more people has never been easier with Adobe Acrobat's Sign tool. In this tutorial, learn how to use the Sign tool to send and receive signed agreements using a web browser or mobile device. Hi everyone, my name is Angelo Montilla from MontillaDesign.com. I'm an Adobe certified designer, trainer, and YouTube content creator. Let's jump in and learn more about the Sign tool in Adobe Acrobat. On my screen, I have a wedding event planning proposal, and I'd like to send this document out for an e-signature. Now, there are a few ways of accessing the Request e-signatures tool. First, click on the All Tools panel, and you'll notice that it's an option here in the menu, Request e-signatures. There's also a Request e-signatures button option below where you can access the tool quickly. Finally, you can also click the eSign tab located in the upper left-hand corner to access the Request e-signatures tool. I'm going to go ahead and click this option, which brings up another window to add recipients. Here, you can add the email address of one or more recipients you would like to add as signers. I'm going to add one email recipient. You can click the plus icon to add more recipients, add yourself to the recipient chain, or add carbon copy emails. For this example, I'm only going to send this document to one recipient. Let's move on to the next step by clicking Prepare Document. You can now click the field in the form or document where you would like the recipient to sign. For example, if I hover over the client signature field, Acrobat automatically detects that that's an area for an e-signature. You can see that because the cursor has changed to an e-signature icon. So I'm going to go ahead and click that, and you'll notice that it's now an e-signature field. I could still change the type of signature I'd like. We have it set to e-signature, but you have some other options here. You can also set this as a required field. You could do the same thing with the date. If I hover over the date, you could see that Acrobat automatically detects that that is a date field, and the icon has changed to a calendar icon. Once you see that, go ahead and click that field, and now this is a date field. You could choose your date format. There's many here to choose from. I think I like the one that's currently selected, so I'll leave it at that. And much like the e-signature field, we could set this as a required field. Once you have the e-signature and the date fields set, let's go ahead and click Review and Send. Here, you can review all the details before sending it to the recipient. You could set an agreement name. You could see it's called Wedding Venue Agreement. You could see here there's a generic message. However, I'm going to update it with my own personalized message for Mike. On the right side of the screen, you have options to set reminders until the agreement is completed. As a default, it'll be set to every week. You have some other options here, and if you didn't want a frequency of reminders to be sent, just click None. I think I'm going to leave this on every week. As a final step, let's go ahead and click Send. You can click the Track This Agreement option or select View in Agreements for the same result. This brings up all your agreements in Adobe Acrobat. And you can see the agreement that's just been sent is at the very top of the list. Here, it displays the date it was sent, received, the sender, and the status of the agreement. If I click the agreement, you can track the activity, cancel the agreement, or send additional reminders. For example, if a week has passed and you'd like to send the recipient another reminder to sign the document, click Reminders, add another personalized message, and then click Send. The recipient will receive a link via email and will be able to launch the PDF in Acrobat on the web to sign the agreement. The recipient can also date the document before clicking Submit to finalize the agreement, which sends a copy to the sender. And once the document's been signed, you'll notice that the status says completed. You're now ready to confidently request e-signatures and manage agreements with Adobe Acrobat. Use these techniques in your own PDFs and make sending documents for e-signatures a breeze. Again, my name is Angelo Montilla, and I'll see you in the next video.